आज 11 अप्रैल को महान समाज सुधारक राष्ट्रपिता महात्मा ज्योतिबा फुले जी की 195वीं जयंती पूरे देश में बड़े ही धूमधाम से मनाई गई। इसी क्रम में जनित आवाज की टीम पहुंची फरीदाबाद हरियाणा के रतन कॉन्वेंट स्कूल में। रतन कॉन्वेंट स्कूल द्वारा महात्मा फुले जी के जीवन पर प्रकाश डालने के लिए छात्रों का एक सेमिनार आयोजित किया गया, जिसमें मुख्य अतिथि रिटायर्ड आईपीएस श्री आरएस चौहान जी रहे एवं विशिष्ट अतिथि श्रीमती सुनीता चौहान जी रही। इनके अलावा इस प्रोग्राम में रतन कॉन्वेंट स्कूल के प्रिंसिपल मनोज नागौरिया जी, अनेक छात्र छात्रा व विद्यालय का स्टाफ एवं प्रतियोगिता के जज भी उपस्थित रहे। श्री चौहान द्वारा प्रथम, द्वितीय और तृतीय स्थान प्राप्त करने वाले छात्र छात्राओं को नगद इनाम देकर प्रोत्साहित भी किया गया। छात्रों ने महामानव ज्योतिबा फुले के जीवन पर प्रकाश डाला, तो आइए जानते हैं विद्यालय के नन्हे मुन्ने छात्रों द्वारा महात्मा फुले के बारे में क्या कहा।
सुप्रभात मुख्य अतिथि, माननीय मुख्य अध्यापक जी, शिक्षकगण एवं मेरे सप्रिय सहपाठियों, मेरा नाम जिया है। मैं कक्षा 8वीं बी की छात्रा हूँ। आज मैं आपके समक्ष ज्योतिबा फुले पे भाषण प्रस्तुत करने जा रही हूँ। महात्मा ज्योतिबा फुले का जन्म 11 अप्रैल 1827 में पुणे में हुआ था। उनकी माता का नाम चिमनाबाई तथा पिता का नाम गोविंदराव था। उनका परिवार कई पीढ़ी पहले पानी का काम करता था। वे सतारा से पुणे फूल लाकर फूलों के गजरे आदि बनाने का काम करते थे, इसलिए उनकी पीढ़ी पुणे के नाम से जानी जाती थी। ज्योतिबा बहुत बुद्धिमान थे। उन्होंने मराठी में अध्ययन किया। वे महान क्रांतिकारी, भारतीय विचारकर, समाज सेवी, लेखक एवं दार्शनिक थे। 1840 में ज्योतिबा का विवाह सावित्रीबाई से हुआ। सावित्रीबाई भारत की प्रथम अध्यापिका थी। इस समय महाराष्ट्र में जाति प्रथा बड़े ही विभत्स रूप में फैली हुई थी। स्त्रियों की शिक्षा को लेकर लोग उदासीन थे। ऐसे में ज्योतिबा फुले ने समाज को इन कृत्यों से मुक्त करने के लिए बड़े पैमाने पर आंदोलन चलाए। उन्होंने महाराष्ट्र में सर्वप्रथम महिला शिक्षा तथा अछूत होकर का काम आरंभ किया था। उन्होंने पुणे में लड़कियों के लिए भारत का पहला विद्यालय खोला। इन प्रमुख सुधार आंदोलन के अतिरिक्त हर क्षेत्र में छोटे छोटे आंदोलन जारी थे, जिसके सामाजिक और बौद्धिक स्तर पर लोगों में नए विचार, नए चिंतन की शुरुआत हुई, जो आज़ादी की लड़ाई में उनके संभल बने। इस महान समाज सेवी ने अछोदर के लिए सत्य शोधक समाज स्थापित किया था। उनका यह भाव देखकर 1888 में उन्हें महात्मा की उपाधि दी गई थी। ज्योतिबा गोविंदराव फुले की मृत्यु 28 नवंबर 1890 पुणे में हुई थी। धन्यवाद।
अ वेरी हेल्दी गुड मॉर्निंग टू रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल सर, ऑनरेबल जज, वर्दी टीचर्स एंड ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स। I, Jessica, from class 7C, standing here in front of you to speak on Shri Jyotiraw Phule. First, I think I am so fortunate as I am give chance by my teachers to express my views on such a great personality. Jyotiraw Phule was born in Satara district of Maharashtra on 11 April 1827. His father name was Govindrao Phule and his mother name was Chumbabai. He belongs to the Mali caste. He was prominent social reformer and thinker of 19th century. He led the movement against the prevailing the caste restriction in India. He was also a pioneer for women's education in India and fought for girls' education throughout his life. His work extends for many fields, including eradication of untouchability, caste system, and his effort for women's education and oppressed caste people. At the age of just 13 years, he married at Savatri. He and his wife pioneer for women's education. He started his first school for girls in 1849 at Pune. He, along with his followers, formed the Satyashodhak Samaj to attain the people from lower caste. He worked against the gender discrimination and caste discrimination. He died at the age of 63 years on 28 November 1890. Thank you and have a nice day.
I present a warm welcome to all the participants, respected Principal Sir, Honorable Chief Guest, worthy teachers and all my dear fellow mates. This gathering is the display of the personality of our school and I am proud to be a part of it. Today we are here to celebrate the birth anniversary of Sri Jyotiba Rao Phule, and I, Tanisha Tanwar from Class 12th Medical, is here to speak some lines about him. Phule was born on 11 April 1827 and died on 28 November 1890. He worked towards eradicating untouchability and the caste system. He belongs to Shudras, that is lower caste according to the Hindu caste system. Phule, on 24 September 1873, along with his followers, formed a Satyashodhak Samaj, that is Society of the Seekers of Truth, to attain equal rights for economically disadvantaged people and people from underprivileged groups. Phule is regarded as an important figure for social reform movement in Maharashtra. He and his wife, Savitri Bai Phule, were pioneers of women education in India. He is most known for his efforts he made to educate women and lower caste people. Phule first started a school in August 1848 for girls, and later he started schools for children from Dalit caste of Mahar and Mang. He is champion as the remarriage of widows for and started a home for upper caste and lower caste widows, as well as for newborn infants to prevent female infanticide. He tried to eliminate the stigma of untouchability that surround the lower caste by opening his home and the use of water well by the member of lower caste. At last, I pay my tribute to Mahatma Jyotiba Rao Phule, who worked and strive for equal rights for all, regardless of caste and creed, and worked for the upliftment of downtrodden and women education. Let us follow the path shown by him. Thank you.
A very healthy good morning to the respected principal sir, honorable judges, worthy teachers and all my dear fellow mates. Today I, Kajal from class 10, standing in front of you all to speak some lines on Sri Jyotirao Phule. Jyotirao Phule was born on 11 April 1827 in Gadgaon, Satara district of Maharashtra. He was an Indian social reformer and a thinker who worked towards equality regardless of caste. He was a thinker and also a writer. His work related mainly to the eradication of untouchability and caste system, emancipation and empowerment of women. His family belonged to the Gore caste, which was considered lowly. Due to their expertise in selling and growing flowers, they took up the surname of Phule. He also known as the Mahatma Phule. He was dead on 28 November 1819. He also opened up his wells for the low caste peoples. He coined up the word Dalit for the downtrodden lower caste peoples, meaning crushed and broken in Marathi. He also formed Satyashodhak Samaj, demanding equal rights for all the people from lower castes in 1873. Thank you.
What a wonderful speech. Now I would like to call Shweta from class 12th. Give a big hand of applause.
A very happy and healthy good morning to all. I, Shweta from class 12th. Today we are going to talk about Mahatma Jyotirao Phule. It is my honor to talk about such a great social reformer. Mahatma Jyotirao Phule was a social reformer, writer, leader, revolutionary, and I think more appropriate word is sent for him. He strived hard to change the Indian society, which was drenched in various social evils like caste discrimination, gender inequalities, and inhuman treatment with widows. I want to grab this opportunity and work and grace and urge millions of people who still don't believe in equality between men and women. Because Mahatma Phule was an educated and a modern man even 150 years ago. He strived hard to change the society and he smashed all the orthodox thoughts and provided education to his wife Jyotirao Phule. He strived hard and educated women and uplifted their morale. He worked as a bright light of hope for the women, untouchables and widows. He provided shelter to the widows who are thrown out of their houses and out of the society. In 63 years of lifespan, he worked selflessly and tirelessly. His life taught us a great lesson that nothing is impossible if we are determined and are on a right path. It is my honor to talk about such a great social reformer, Jyotirao Phule. Jyotirao Phule was a great social reformer, writer, revolutionary, and I think more appropriate word is sent for him. He strived hard to change the Indian society, which was drenched in various social evils like gender inequality, caste discrimination, and I think he did several social activities also. So,
a very delightful good morning to honorable judges, honorable principals, sir, teachers, and all my fellow mates. Today, I am going to talk about a very auspicious and very great social reformer, Jyotiba Phule. Mahatma Jyotiba Phule was a social reformer, writer, and a revolutionary. I think that the most appropriate word for Jyotiba Phule is a saint. He was born in the small village of Maharashtra in the family of Govindrao Phule and Chimna Phule on 11 April 1827. Jyotiba belonged to a Mali caste. He strived hard to change the Indian society, which was reached in the social evils like gender inequality, caste discrimination, and inhuman treatment with the widows. I want to grab an opportunity to argue with the millions of people who say that the women are not equal to the men. The Mahatma Phule was a modern man even 150 years ago. He smashed the orthodox thought and educated his wife Savitri Bai Phule, which was a rare among the rarest gesture of this era, and showed that he was a great and strong advocate of the woman empowerment. He worked as a bright light of hope of women's untouchables and who faced the several inhuman aristocracy. He provided shelter to women who uplifted through their houses. He uplifted the women by providing them education and that boosted their moral support. In the 63 years of lifespan, he worked tirelessly, selflessly. His life taught a great lesson that nothing is impossible. We determined and we are on a real right path. He opened our eyes about the importance of education. Mahatma Phule and his follower founded Satya Sodhak Samaj, which means the seekers of truth, in order to attain equal economic benefits for the lower caste of Maharashtra. But still millions of our fellow brother and sister lagging behind because of the poverty, illiteracy, unemployment, and corruption, insecurity, etc. A question arises that how we can change our society. If the Mahatma Phule inspired that little drops can make an education, make an solution. Now come forward to educate those people who work for us, like maids, small vendor, etc. Mahatma Phule wrote many of the books that contribute to the social awakening of whole country. One of his famous book, Gulami, dedicated to end the slavery movement to African American. The best word title of Mahatma Mahatma was given to the Jyotirao Phule on 11 May 1888 by the Maharashtrian social activist Vithal Rao Krishnanji Vedankar. On the 28th November 1890, the world has lost a great social reformer, Jyotiba Phule, but the Mahatma Jyotiba Phule always live in our thoughts. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, Andriksh. Now, I would like to call Harshita from class 10th. Give a big hand.
A very healthy good morning to respected chief guest, worthy teachers, respected principal sir, and all my fellow mates. I, Harshita, from class 10, is standing before you all to speak some lines based on the life and exemplary work of Sri Govindrao Phule, who was an eminent educationalist and a social reformer. I think I am so fortunate that I am given this chance by my teachers to express my views on such a great personality. Without education, wisdom was lost. Without wisdom, morals were lost. Without morals, development was lost. Without development, wealth was lost. Without wealth, sudras were ruined. So much has happened through lack of education. So, Jyoti Rao Phule played a major role in improving the education. Jyoti Rao Phule occupied a unique position among the social reformer of the Maharashtra in the 19th century. He was born on 11th April 1827 at the Satara district. He was from Mali community. His father name was Sri Govind Rao Phule. His mother name was Sri Chiman Phule. His financial condition was not so good, so he couldn't able to took admission in such a great school. But fortunately, he got admission at the Scottish Mission High School at Pune. It was the turning point in his life because he came into contact with the Brahmin friends and missionaries of humanity. While other reformers concentrated more on reforming the social condition of the family and the marriage of the woman, which specially emphasizes the status and the right of the woman. On 1848, an incident sparked of Jyotiba quest against the social institution of caste discrimination and insistence of social revolution in the Indian society. In 1851, he established girls' school and asked his wife, Savitri Bai Phule, to teach the girl in that school. In 1873, he formed Satya Sodak Samaj with his followers, and also very successfully in 1873, he wrote a book named Gulamgiri, and he dedicated his book Gulamgiri to the American movement to free slaves, because the condition of the black slaves of America was similar to that of the condition of the low caste people of India. Jyoti Rao Phule devoted his entire life for the liberation of the exploitation of Brahmins. He suffered a stroke in 1888 and was rendered paralyzed. On 28 November 1890, the great social reformer Jyoti Rao passed away. I salute such a great personality. Jai Hind!
Wow, what an outstanding performance. Now I invite Nisha from class 9th.
Good morning, respected principal sir, honorable judges, and worthy teachers and all my dear friends. I am Nisha, student of 9th A. Today I deliver a speech on topic Jyoti Rao Phule. Before starting my speech, I would like to thanks to my teacher who gives me this golden opportunity. Who's, many people don't know about him. Who is Jyoti Rao Phule? Anyone? No, I tell you. He was a social reformer who dedicated his life for Dalits, women upliftment. He was born on 11th April in 1827 into a Mali family. His father, Govind Rao, was a vegetable vendor at Pune. Jyoti Rao's mother passed away when he was just 9 months old. He was belonged to a poor family due to financial condition. He had stopped his studies at an early age. Thank you.
Now I would like to call Riya Chaudhary from class 10th for a speech.
A very delightful good morning to honorable judges, respected principal sir, worthy teachers, and my dear fellow mates. Today, I, Ria from class 10th, is standing in front of you all to speak some lines on Indian social activist, thinker and writer Shri Jyoti Rao Phule. I think I am a fortunate fellow as I am privileged to share my views on such a great personality. Shri Jyoti Rao Phule was born on 11th April 1827 in a family that belonged to lower rung of the social ladder. He is remembered as the champion of women's education in India. He, along with his wife, Shri Savitri Rai Phule, opened the first school for girls in India in 1848. Shri Jyoti Rao Phule was honored with the title Mahatma, which means great soul in Sanskrit. In 1873, Shri Jyoti Rao Phule formed a reform society named Satya Shodhak Samaj, to promote social equality, unity, and uplifting of untouchables. He revolted against the dominations of Brahmins and struggled for the rights of peasants and other low caste people. His contribution to the girls' education and empowerment of women was enormous. He was a great person. On 28 November 1890, we lost him. His aim was that girls could get maximum education so it's our duty to fulfill his goal and achieve success. Thank you.
Wow, what a wonderful performance. Now I would like to call Sunita from class 10th for a speech.
A very delightful good morning to honorable judges, respected principal sir, worthy teacher, and all my dear fellow mate. Today I, Sunita, from 10th A, standing here you all to speak some line on Jyoti Rao Phule. I think I am fortunate as I am given a chance by my teacher to explain my view on such great personality. Jyoti Rao Phule was born on 11 April 1827. He was an Indian social thinker, activist, anti-caste, social reformer, and writer from Maharashtra. He worked very hard to abolish the untouchability and the caste system. His wife, Savitri Rai Phule, became the first female teacher in India and opened a school for girls in 1848. His contribution to the educating of women and empowerment of women was enormous. Phule was best known for his work in educating of women. He also established a Satya Shodhakar Samaj with the ideas of human well-being, happiness, unity, equality. He was best owned with honorific award by Maharashtrian Social Anti-Caste in 1888. He suffered a paralytic stroke in 1888. He died in 28 November 1888. Thank you. Have a good day.
Now I would like to call Yuvraj from class 10th.
For you to speak about some lines on Jyoti Rao Phule. Jyoti Rao Phule was a prominent social reformer and a thinker of India who was born in 1827. He is remembered as the soul of women's education in India as he had a great effort towards it. His wife Savitri Bai Phule supported him for providing right to education to women. So in 1951, Jyoti Rao Phule established the first school in India for girls and asked her wife to teach in the schools. After that, he opened two more schools for girls and established a indigenous school for lower castes. Jyoti Rao Phule also realized the pathetic conditions of widows and established the ashrams for widows. And eventually he became the advocate of the widow remarriage idea.
Thank you for a great speech. Now I would like to call Bhavya from class 5th, because now it's time for junior classes to represent their speeches. Now I would like to call Bhavya from class 5th. Give a big hand.
Good morning, honorable judges, respected principal sir, chief guests, and my worthy teachers. I am Bhavya from class 5th. Today I am telling about Mr. Jyotirao Phule. Jyotirao Phule's full name was Jyotirao Govindrao Phule. People also know him as Jyotirao Phule and Mahatma Phule. He was born on 11 April 1827, Satara district, Maharashtra. Jyotirao Phule was an Indian social activist, anti-caste, a thinker and a writer. He got married to Savitri Bai Phule at the age of 13 years. Jyotirao Phule's father name was Govindrao Phule and mother was Chimanbai Phule. He completed his English from a local school. He taught his wife. He and his wife opened first school for girls on 1st January 1848 at Bhide Wale, Pune.
Dear students, the students must have prepared their notes. They can speak by reading whatever they have collected information regarding the legendary man. So it is also allowed. You can speak by reading. Okay, there is no problem. It is also welcomed. And on this occasion, I am putting some enlightening over some points. So I want to tell to the chief guest that these students were informed only on Saturday. Saturday is actually, it was holiday in our school. They were just informed on WhatsApp that you have to prepare on this topic and you will speak in front of the students and chief guests and judges. So this is the work they have done within 1.5 days. Saturday evening, they were informed. And evening they have prepared, on Sunday they have prepared only. So now I really appreciate the work of children, those who are facing the stage, speaking on mic, it's a wonderful achievement. So we should clap for them, those who have already spoken and are going to speak. So really I appreciate their work. So, and in coming days, I can assure they will do better and reach to the best levels. So next.
Mahatma Jyotirao Phule was born on 11th April 1827. He was a great freedom fighter. His father's name is Govindrao Phule and his mother's name is Chimanbai Phule. His wife Savitri Bai Phule and he start India's first school on 1st January 1848 at Pune, Maharashtra.
Respected principal sir, chief guests and all enders, my name is Ritika. I study in 5th class. I am here before you to represent speech.
A very healthy good morning to honorable judge, respected principal sir, worthy teachers and all my dear friends. Today I am Nick from class 5th standing here before all to speak some lines on Mahatma Jyotirao Phule. Mahatma Jyotirao Phule was born on 11th April 1827 in Pune, Maharashtra. Phule was born in a family that belongs to the lower rung of the social ladder. His family belonged to the Meli caste. Jyotiba Phule was an Indian social activist, thinker, anti-caste social reformer and writer from Maharashtra. On 1st January 1848, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule and Savitribai Phule began India's first girls' school at Bidewada in Pune. Savitribai Phule became India's first woman teacher in 1848 and opened girls' school with her husband Jyotiba Phule. He led the movement of the against prevailing caste restriction in India.
19वीं सदी से प्रमुख समाज सेवक माना जाता था। उन्होंने भारतीय समाज में अनेक बुराइयों को दूर करने के लिए हर संभव संघर्ष किए। छोटी जाति, नारी शिक्षा, विधवा विवाह और किसानों के हित में अनेक कार्य किए। उनका जन्म 11 अप्रैल 1827 को महाराष्ट्र में सतारे जिले में हुआ था। धन्यवाद।
महात्मा ज्योतिराव फुले, जिनका पूरा नाम ज्योतिराव गोविंदराव फुले है, उनका जन्म 11 अप्रैल 1827 को सतारा महाराष्ट्र में हुआ था। वे गरीबों की बहुत ही सहायता करते थे। छोटी जाति, नारी शिक्षा, विधवा विवाह और किसानों के हित में रह के वो बहुत ही कार्य किया करते थे। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू वंदना। नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल प्राची फ्रॉम क्लास 5th।
गुड मॉर्निंग रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल सर, टीचर्स एंड ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स। टुडे आई एम प्राची From class 5th, I am here to represent a speech on Jyotirao Phule. Jyotirao Phule complete name was Jyotirao Govindrao Phule. People also known as Jyotiba Phule and Mahatma Phule. Jyotiba got married to Savitri Phule at a very young age, 13 years. He was born in Maharashtra in 1827 in Mali caste. His family was illiterate, but he completed his English schooling from a local missionary school. In 1847, he taught his wife to read and write, the raised his voice for women to provide them right to education. He died on 28 November 1819 and every year his birthday is celebrated on 11 April across the world. Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, Prachi, for a grateful performance. Now I would like to call Anushka from class 7.
My name is Anushka Hans from 7th standard. I'm here for a speech.
Anushka, now I would like to call Gorangi from class 6th.
Good morning, respected principal, honorable chief guest and all my dear friends. I am Gorangi from 6th class. Today I would like to represent for Jyotirao Phule. Jyotirao Phule was born on 11 April 1827 in the village of Katgun, Satara district, Maharashtra. He also known as Jyotirao Govindrao Phule or Mahatma Phule. His father name was Govindrao Phule and mother name was Chimanabai Phule. He was married with Savitri Bai Phule at the early age of 13 in 1840. He also known as Jyotir. He was an Indian social activist as well as a writer. He belongs to Shudra's lower caste. He worked hard to remove social reforms like untouchability, educating women and caste system. He started his first school for girls in 1848. In Pune, he founded Satyashodhak Samaj to attain equal rights for people from lower castes. He was bestowed with honorific title Mahatma by Vitthal Rao Krishnaji in 1888. He wrote the famous book Gulamgiri. He suffered from paralytic stroke few years before his death. He died at the age of 63 on 28 November 1890 in Pune, Maharashtra. Thank you.
Thank you, Gaurangi, for this beautiful speech. Now I would like to call Gitika from class 5th.
Suprabhat. Suprabhat, Adane Vidhanacharya ji, Mukhya Atithi, Manya Mukhadhyapak, Jeev, Shikshakgan, Ve Mere Sabhi सहपाठियों सुप्र मेरा नाम गीतिका है. मैं कक्षा पाँचवीं की छात्रा हूँ. मैं आज आपके सामने ज्योतिराव फुले जी को भाषण प्रस्तुत करने जा रही हूँ. मंदिर का मतलब होता है मानसिक गुलामी का रास्ता. स्कूल का मतलब होता है जीवन में प्रकाश का रास्ता. मंदिर की जब घंटी बजती है तो हमें ये संदेश देती है कि हम धर्म अंधविश्वास पाखंड और मूर्खता की ओर बढ़ रहे हैं. वही जब स्कूल की घंटी बजती है तो ये संदेश देती है कि हम तर्कपूर्ण ज्ञान और विज्ञानिता की ओर बढ़ रहे हैं. अब तय आपको करना होगा कि आपको जाना कहाँ है. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू गीतिका. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल जय फ्रॉम क्लास 5th.
प्रभात. आदरणीय प्रधानाचार्य जी, मुख्य अतिथि, माननीय न्यायालयों, अध्यापकगण व मेरे प्रिय सहपाठियों, आज मैं श्री ज्योतिराव फूले के बारे में अपने विचार देने के लिए यहाँ पांचवी कक्षा से जय हूँ. मुझे लगता है कि मैं बहुत भाग्यशाली हूँ क्योंकि मुझे मेरे अध्यापकों द्वारा ऐसे महान व्यक्ति पर अपने विचार व्यक्त करने का मौका दिया गया है. श्री ज्योतिराव फूले का जन्म 11 अप्रैल 1827 में हुआ था. एक भारतीय समाज सुधारक, समाज प्रबोधक, विचारक, समाजसेवी, लेखक, दार्शनिक तथा क्रांतिकारी कार्यकर्ता थे. इन्हें महात्मा फूले एवं ज्योतिबा फूले के नाम से भी जाना जाता था. सितंबर 1873 में इन्होंने महाराष्ट्र में सत्यशोधक समाज नामक संस्था का गठन किया. महिलाओं के योगदान के लिए इन्होंने अनेक कार्य किए. समाज के सभी वर्गों को शिक्षा प्रदान करने के लिए यह प्रबल समर्थक थे. वह भारतीय समाज में प्रचलित जाति पर आधारित विभाजन और भेदभाव के विरुद्ध थे. इनका मूल उद्देश्य स्त्रियों को शिक्षा का अधिकार प्रदान करना, बाल विवाह का विरोध और विधवा विवाह का समर्थन करना रहा था. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू जय. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल प्रतिज्ञा फ्रॉम क्लास 7th.
गुड मॉर्निंग टू चीफ गेट्स एंड प्रिंसिपल सर प्रेजेंट हेयर. आई एम प्रतिज्ञा स्टैंडिंग हेयर टू डिलीवर माई स्पीच ऑन ज्योतिराव फूले. ज्योतिराव फूले's complete name was Jyotirao Govind Phule. People also know him as Jyotiba Phule and Mahatma Phule. Jyotirao got married to Savitri Phule at very young age of 13 years. He was born in Satara district of Mahasatra in Malis Kas. He taught his wife to read and write and raised his voice for women to provide them right to education. He opened an indigenous school for lower caste and girls. He wrote drama like Satsar and books like Satya Shodhak Samaj. He died on 28 November, and every year his birthday is celebrated on 11 April across the world. I hope you will like my speech. Thank you.
Thank you, Pratigya. Now I would like to call Sakshi from class 6th. Give a big hand.
Good morning, principal sir, teachers, and dear my friend, chief guest. My name is Sakshi. I am from 6th B class. Today I am going to tell you about Jyotirao Phule. Jyotirao Phule, also known as Jyotirao Govinda Phule or Mahatma Phule. He was born on 11 April 1827 in the village of Katgar, Satara district, Maharashtra. Jyotirao Phule father was Govinda Phule and mother was Chimane Phule. Jyotirao Phule also appointed of member of municipal council of Pune in 1876. Jyotirao Phule got married Savitri Bai Phule at the early age of 13 year. Jyotirao Phule, he and his wife Savitri Bai established India's first school for girls 1898. He died on November 28, 1890. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Now I would like to call Kanishka from class 6th. Give a big hand.
Good morning, Principal Sir, teachers and my friends and chief guest. Today, my name is Kanishka Vagher in 6th class. Today I speak in Jyotibarao Phule. Jyotibarao Phule was born on 11 April 1827 in Pune. His father name was Govindra Rao Phule and his mother name was Chimna Bai Phule. His wife name was Savitri Bai Phule. He opposed the evil practices in the society and emphasized on sexual matter right.
So I think all participants have participated. And now we are waiting for the result. Okay, let's see. As per the observations of the honorable guests and judges, okay, they are preparing the result on the basis of the participants' performance. So wait for a while. Once the result is prepared, and then will be announced. So meanwhile, if any students want to speak or want to share their views on the occasion of birth anniversary of Mahatma Jyotibarao Phule, they are also welcome. Even teachers can also speak if they have their views. Because in our teaching industry or in this teaching arena, the most of the teachers are female. So this is, he was a role model for the female teachers, and especially his wife worked a lot for the female education. And gradually and slowly, his light was forward to the different people, and many social reformers worked on the guidance and path shown by the Mahatma Jyotibarao Phule and Savitri Bai Phule. So there are so many people, those who worked on women education and still working. Still, there are so many differences in our societies, and there are many women or female child who are not getting opportunity to study equally as male child. So there is a need to work upon as a teacher from our part. So if anybody wants to speak, can come forward. Or we are also waiting for the result. So results have been prepared or not? Invite Honorable Chief Guest Sri R.S. Chauhanji, IPS. He has served as a superintendent of police in New Delhi and worked a lot. His work is also remarkable for the society and for the women education, for the children's education, for the people of deprived people. He also worked a lot, and still he is working at this age. He and his wife really doing remarkable work through the organization of Bharat Ekta Samrastha Trust and some other organizations. So I request him to come upon the dais and share his views. Thank you. Please welcome, sir.
Thank you. Respected Principal Saab, respected faculty members, judges, Srimati Sunita Chauhan, members from media, and my dear students. We all must be very thankful to the college authorities for organizing this very wonderful program on such a grand personality. First of all, I must pay my respectful tribute to such a great personality who was educationalist, social reformer par excellence. I have heard speeches of all the students. Every student has made his or her best efforts for speaking upon such a great personality. We must be thankful to all of them. They have started thinking about their education, their social reforms, and their rights as well. Some of you have spoken in English and some of you have spoken in Hindi. So I will be bilingual. Any problems? All right. I think I should not repeat whatever has already been said regarding his date of birth, his marriage, his social organizations established, like Satya Sodhak Samaj, everybody has spoken. Like everybody has spoken, the first school established by his wife Savitri Bai Phule. He has written so many books. Many of them have also counted the name of books. What is written in those books? These books are also available online. You must also read out those books. And most prominent book is Gulamgiri. So I must suggest that everybody go online and read out whatever he has written. In very simple language, I will try to explain what he did. You must be knowing who was Galileo. What he invented, Galileo was a scientist. He invented telescope, rather improved upon telescope, and he invented compass, thermometer, and also other things. Hydrostatic balance, you must know whatever he did. So he was also known for a theory, what he did with telescope. He experimented with telescope and came to a conclusion that Earth is geocentric. Heliocentric and geocentric, you must be knowing. I will explain. Geocentric and heliocentric. Heliocentric means Earth revolves round the sun. Do you know solar system? Geography you must be reading. Earth revolves around the sun. But there was also a theory prevalent on those times which is called geocentric. Means जमीन जो है अर्थ है एक ग्रह है उसके चारों ओर सभी ग्रह घूमते हैं. ये किसका मानना था? ये चर्च का, कैथोलिक चर्च का ये मानना था कि अर्थ के चारों ओर सारे ग्रह घूमते हैं. लेकिन टेलीस्कोप से गैलीलियो ने पता लगाया कि अर्थ के चारों ओर नहीं घूमते, अर्थ भी एक ग्रह है, सूर्य के चारों ओर घूमते हैं. तो ये चर्च वालों को पसंद नहीं आया ये सिद्धांत. टेलीस्कोप से देख के, देखिए साहब दो चीज़ें होती हैं, एक होती है मान्यताएं, एक होते हैं सिद्धांत. मान्यताओं का मतलब होता है मान लीजिए, जैसे आप मानते हैं मानव संख्या 100 है, मान लीजिए, मतलब तर्क नहीं करना है, उनको मान लीजिए, वो मान्यताएं हैं. एक होता है सिद्धांत जो सिद्ध करना पड़ता है, जो प्रिंसिपल्स, आप गणित में प्रिंसिपल्स पढ़ते हैं, ए स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस बी स्क्वायर थीटा इज इक्वल टू सो एंड सो, देन यू कम टू प्रूव इट. सो ये सिद्धांत है, सिद्धांत को प्रूव करना पड़ता है. गैलीलियो ने क्या किया कि अर्थ नहीं घूम, अर्थ जो है अपनी किली पर भी घूमती है, सूर्य के चारों ओर भी घूमती है. तो टेलीस्कोप के थ्रू उसने देखा, मैग्नीफाइंग ग्लास से लेके उसने फिर शुरू किया, बड़ा इम्प्रूव किया उस पर. जुपिटर का भी सैटेलाइट होता है, उसने खोजा, जुपिटर का सैटेलाइट होता है, उसने पता लगाया और बताया कि अर्थ और ये ग्रह जो हैं सूर्य के चारों ओर घूमते हैं, ना कि पृथ्वी के चारों ओर घूमते हैं. तो जो चर्च था, कैथोलिक चर्च, जो वहाँ ऑर्थोडॉक्स लोग थे, वो नाराज़ हो गए गैलीलियो से, बहुत नाराज़ हो गए. एक बार तो उसको माफ़ कर दिया वार्निंग देके. दोबारा फिर उसने और रिसर्च किया, तो गैलीलियो को ट्रायल किया उन्होंने. गैलीलियो वाज ट्रायल, उसको फिर पनिशमेंट भी दिया और हाउस अरेस्ट कर दिया और उसको मार दिया घर पे. तो गैलीलियो आज की डेट में देखें तो आप पढ़ते हैं, तो गैलीलियो बेशक मार दिया हो, लेकिन गैलीलियो तो आज भी जिंदा है ना, जिंदा है कि नहीं? क्योंकि उसका विचार जिंदा है, उसका विचार जिंदा है तो गैलीलियो जिंदा है. तो चर्च के जो लोग ऑर्थोडॉक्स थे, जो उल्टा विचार रखते थे, वो लोग तो आज नहीं हैं, उनको तो कोई नहीं जानता. अब 400 साल बाद अब इटली वाले लोग भी कहते हैं कि हाँ हम अभी मानते हैं गैलीलियो सही कहता था, गैलीलियो सही कहता था. तो ये जो विचारधारा है, जो कंसेप्ट है, जो सिद्धांत है, सच क्या है, झूठ क्या है, सत्य शोधक समाज इज ट्रूथ सीकर्स, सत्य को खोजो, सत्य पे खोज करना है, सत्य क्या है, झूठ क्या है, तो मान लेते हैं. तो अगर हम गैलीलियो को छोड़ दें, अभी आप समझ गए होंगे कि वो सिद्धांत पे आधारित था, साइंटिफिक था, और जो चर्च थी, जो ऑर्थोडॉक्स थी, जिन्होंने उसको सजा सुनाई, जो मार दिया, वो लोग गलत सिद्ध हुए. तो अगर हम भारत में देखें, तो अगर आप गुलामगिरी पढ़ेंगे, तो गुलामगिरी में एक इंडियन कंसेप्ट को उन्होंने क्रिटिसाइज किया है. वो क्रिटिसाइज क्या है कि यहाँ पर एक थ्योरी होती है कि क्रिएशन ऑफ वर्ल्ड, रचना कैसे हुई, सृष्टि की रचना कैसे हुई. तो वो सृष्टि की रचना जो कुछ लोग हैं, जो यहाँ भी ऑर्थोडॉक्स होते हैं, हर जगह पाए जाते हैं, तो जो ऑर्थोडॉक्स थ्योरी है वो कहती है कि जो सृष्टि की रचना है वो वर्णाश्रम धर्म वर्णाश्रम है जो चार वर्ण है उस हिसाब से होती है, और भगवान ने जो है उनको चारों वर्णों को अपने अलग अलग अंगों से पैदा किया है, किसी को मुंह से, किसी को बाजू से, किसी को ताई से, किसी को बैली से, किसी को पैर से, ऐसे पैदा किया है। तो गुलामगिरी बेसिकली इस थ्योरी को नेगेट करने के लिए उसमें तथ्य दिए गए हैं, और उसको कैसे नेगेट किया है वो पढ़ने से आपको पता चलेगा। बहुत सॉलिड उसमें कई साइंटिफिक चीज़ें हैं, तो वो नहीं होना है। अब उसमें जैसे चार वर्ण को तो बता दिया कि चार अंगों से पैदा हुए हैं, लेकिन बाकी लोग भी बच जाते हैं उस चार वर्णों में जो नहीं आते हैं, तो उनका सृष्टि कैसे हुआ फिर? तो वो बहुत सारे सवाल हैं। मान लीजिए इंडिया में तो ऐसे हुआ, तो बाहर कैसे हुआ, बाकी देशों में कैसे हुआ? तो वो सारी जो थ्योरी है वो साइंटिफिक बेस्ड है, इसीलिए जो अपना फूले 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 साहब का जो थ्योरी है वो यही है गुलामगिरी में। अब इन्होंने जो काम किया है वो इतना अच्छा है कि अभी एजुकेशन पे जैसे जो वर्ण सिस्टम है उसमें अभी आप जो वोमेन फोक है, लेडीज हैं, गर्ल्स हैं, वो बहुत भाग्यशाली हैं कि फूले साहब के एफर्ट से पहला स्कूल 1 जनवरी 1848 में जो बना वो उनकी मिसेज ने चलाया। उनके पास जगह भी नहीं थी, तो जगह भी नहीं थी, जगह भी किसी दूसरे ने दिया। पहले अपने घर में छोटा चलाए, दूसरे घर में एक दिया, एक मोहम्मदन ने दिया, फातिमा भाई ने दिया, उनका हस्बैंड ने दिया, तो उस घर में चलाया लड़कियों का स्कूल। सभी कोई एक पर्टिकुलर कास्ट का या कोर्स का लड़की के लिए नहीं था वो स्कूल, सबके लिए था। तो वहाँ उनका क्रिटिसिज्म हुआ बहुत। उनकी जो सावित्री बाई फूले थी वो टीचर थी, पढ़ाने जाती थी, तो आपको शायद पता होगा, YouTube पे अगर देखेंगे तो मिल जाएगा, वो वीडियो भी मिल जाएगा। तो वो एक जोड़ी साड़ी अपने थैले में एक्स्ट्रा रखती थी, क्योंकि वो स्कूल जाते जाते उस पर कीचड़ फेंक के लोग जो लाइक नहीं करते थे कि औरतों को शिक्षा नहीं देनी है, तो वो लोग उनकी साड़ी ख़राब कर देते थे उन पर कीचड़ फेंक के, गोबर फेंक के। तो स्कूल में आके वो अपनी साड़ी धोती, अपना दूसरा सेट बदलती थी, फिर बच्चों को पढ़ाती थी। तो लोग बच्चों को मीन्स स्पेशली गर्ल्स को स्कूल नहीं भेजना है। तो जो ये विचारधारा रखते हैं कि गर्ल्स को नहीं पढ़ाना है, अभी शायद आपको पढ़ेंगे, देखिए सभी लोगों ने काफ़ी अध्ययन किया है, मैं समझता हूँ। वर्ण सिस्टम आप जानते हैं, वर्ण सिस्टम में जो चार वर्ण हैं उसमें से स्त्री कौन से वर्ण में आती है? स्त्री जो आती है, चाहे किसी भी कास्ट की हो, स्त्री जो है सबसे नीचे वाले वर्ण में आती है, शूद्राज में आती है। तो शूद्राज, ऑल द शूद्राज इंक्लूडिंग वोमेन डू नॉट हैव एनी राइट टू एजुकेशन, ये जो है मान्यता है, इसका कोई सिद्धांत नहीं, मान्यता है। जैसे उनका चर्च में बाइबल में लिख दिया कि जमीन बिल्कुल सेंटर में है, और अगर आप इस पे चलोगे तो ये फ्लैट है, आप गिर जाओगे, स्पेस में गिर जाओगे, ऐसा उसमें लिखा है बाइबल में। तो यहाँ भी धर्मशास्त्रों में ऐसे लिख दिया कि वुमेन को पढ़ने का अधिकार नहीं है, ऑल वुमेन्स आर शूद्रा। तो इतना बड़ा आबादी, 50% तो होता है लेडीज का, वुमेन का, प्लस उसमें अदर जो वर्ण है शूद्रा जोड़ लिए, तो अबाउट 90% एंड मोर, दिस इज 93% मोर पॉपुलेशन होगा वुमेन को और शूद्राज को लगा लें। तो इतनी बड़ी आबादी को पढ़ने का अधिकार नहीं था, जिसके लिए ज्योतिबा फूले लड़े, बेसिकली लेडीज की एजुकेशन के लिए लड़े। और सावित्री बाई फूले जिस तरह से हिम्मत कई बार उनका टूटा, लेकिन ज्योतिबा फूले साहब ने उनका हिम्मत बढ़ाया, और वो स्कूल चला, लेडीज़ की एजुकेशन शुरू हुई, फिर धीरे धीरे अभी आप यहाँ तक स्कूल तक पहुँचे हैं। यू मस्ट ऑल्सो थैंक ज्योतिबा फूले, ही स्टार्टेड एजुकेशन ऑफ वोमेन, नॉट ओनली एजुकेशन, ही स्टार्टेड विडो रीमैरिज, मैरिज का कॉस्ट कैसे कम करना है, विडोज़ को अगर बच्चा है तो वो कैसे उसका देखभाल और कहाँ कराना है, अस्पताल से लेके। ही ऑल्सो वर्क फॉर इंडस्ट्रियल इकोनॉमिक्स में भी उन्होंने काम किया, एक फैक्ट्री भी लगाया था। तो आपको इकोनॉमिक कैसे बनेंगे आप, उस पर भी बात किया था, उनका खुद का अपना प्रोडक्ट था वो भी करते थे। तो एजुकेशन और सोशल, उनके बराबर मेहनत और जो जद्दोजहद जितना किया उन्होंने, जितना फेस किया, बहुत कुछ फेस किया। जब सत्य शोधक बनाया था समाज तो बहुत लोगों ने बोला था कि आप ये क्यों बना रहे हो, हमारे पास तो ऑलरेडी बहुत सारे समाज हैं, आर्य समाज है, प्रार्थना समाज है और ब्रह्म समाज है, तो आप क्यों बना रहे हो। तो उनका तर्क था कि देखिए इनमें किसी में भी वुमेन का एजुकेशन का बात कहाँ है, सोशल रिफॉर्म का बात कहाँ है। तो वो जो सोशल हायर की है, ज्योतिबा फूले साहब ने कहा कि एक ही भगवान की सब एक ही संतान है, तो आप जो है सब एक समान है, इक्वलिटी के लिए लड़ा। अब इनइक्वलिटी ठीक नहीं है, आप विषमता पे आधारित समाज की स्थापना मत करिए, समता पे आधारित समाज की स्थापना करिए। तो वो इस काम के लिए उन्होंने जद्दोजहद किया, लड़ाई किया। और एक और उन्होंने किया कि ये जो ब्यूरोक्रेसी में जो अरिस्टोक्रेट लोगों का जो सिलेक्शन होता है, वो इंग्लिश टाइम्स में भर्ती में कुछ अरिस्टोक्रेट ही होते थे, तो ब्यूरोक्रेसी में अगर एक ही तरह के लोग हो जाएंगे तो बाकी लोगों के साथ उन्होंने अन्याय किया। वो उसके खिलाफ भी वो लड़े। बहुत सारी चीज़ें हैं आप लोगों ने जो बताए हैं, बेसिकली जो फ्रेटरनिटी ब्रदरहुड और उसके लिए जो काम किया है उनके बराबर किसी ने, मैं नहीं समझता हूँ कि किया है। और बच्चों के लिए, लेडीज़ के लिए, शोषितों के लिए, वंचितों के लिए, उन्होंने सबके लिए ऐसा सिद्धांत बनाए जो आपको मेरे ख्याल से गुलामगिरी ज़रूर पढ़ना चाहिए, ऑनलाइन अवेलेबल है, आप लोग उसे पढ़ेंगे तो वो साइंटिफिक फैक्ट पर आधारित है और डायलॉग फॉर्मेट में है, बहुत बड़ा नहीं है, ये 100-120 पेज का है मुश्किल से, तो आप एक दो दिन ऐसे ही पढ़ जाएंगे। तो आप ऐसा स्कूल अथॉरिटी ने आज इतना अच्छा प्रोग्राम किया है और ये होना चाहिए इस तरह का, जो बहुत ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटीज़ हैं जिनके बारे में लोगों को नहीं पता है, तो ये इनिशिएटिव बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत अच्छा इनिशिएटिव है, इस तरह का होना चाहिए। और बाकी जो छोटे छोटे स्टूडेंट्स ने जो अपना प्रयास किया है बोलने का, बताने का, उनके बारे में पढ़ने का, वो बहुत अच्छा प्रयास है। और आप ऐसे करते रहिए और अच्छे अच्छे लोगों को आप ज़रूर पढ़िए जो इस तरह के काम किए हैं, जो सोशल रिफॉर्मर्स हैं, एजुकेशनलिस्ट हैं, उनको आपको पढ़ना चाहिए, उनसे आपको पता चलेगा कि वेयर आर यू नाउ। एजुकेशन बहुत बड़ा चीज़ है, स्पेशली वुमेन के लिए बहुत बड़ा चीज़ है। थैंक यू वेरी मच, मुझे आपने दिया, Thank you.
So results are prepared for the student. It is a most curious moment that once they are, how their performance is judged and who is getting the first position or second or third. So, okay, let's announce the name of the third position. Two students together. The name of the child, Yashika and Prachi from class 5th. Give them big hands. please come on the stage. These two kids come on the stage of rupees 1100.
Let me tell you, she was so confident when she spoke.
Now, Anushka got seventh position.
Give a big round of applause.
Second.
Sixth has stood on first division, first rank. Gorangi from class 6.
Fourth नहीं बोलना. तू मना कर दिया सर.
Third prize goes to Shweta from class 12th. Second prize goes to Kajal from class 10th. Now everyone is so excited to know about who has stood on first. If you talk about a speech, what are the parameters of a speech? Let me tell you, eloquence, how the speaker speaks, body gestures, confidence, accent, and the speaker must speak wholeheartedly whom he is telling about. So with all the applying all the parameters and successfully achieving it, first prize goes to, of course, Harshita from class 10. Only for one day, but when I checked this final examination English paper, there was a drastic change. He applied fluid and he made a perfect writing of English. So today I can say a different Antariksh. God bless you.
Their anchoring was marvelous, wonderful, and praiseworthy. Clap for them. And consolation prizes for them too. And the teachers, those who are inside the library in this hall, I also thank to them.
Yeah.
And those who prepared, those who judged, and those who managed so many other things, I really thank to them all. And Bharti ma'am, Mr. Anurag sir, Anjali, Yogesh, and cameraman, and our from Janhit Awaz, Voice of People also. I thank to Brijmohan ji, KSG Brijmohan ji, who came from Delhi. Okay.
Yes, so thank you, Principal sir. So, बच्चों जो भी इस प्रोग्राम को देखना चाहते हैं, सबसे पहले तो महात्मा फुले की जयंती की आप सभी को बहुत-बहुत मंगल कामना है. तो आप ये प्रोग्राम देखना चाहते हैं तो YouTube पे सर्च करेंगे जनहित आवाज JANHITAWAZ जनहित आवाज जैसे सर्च करेंगे तो आपको ये प्रोग्राम जो लाइव अभी रिकॉर्ड किया है वो मिल जाएगा. अब बच्चों हम आपके प्रोग्राम को ऐसे ही लगातार बताते रहें. आपकी प्रतिभा जरूर दुनिया के सामने आना चाहिए. जब तक दुनिया आपके बारे में नहीं जानेगी तो प्रतिभा के कोई मायने नहीं रहते हैं. हालांकि प्रतिभा घर में छुपा दी जाती है खास करके इंडिया के अंदर. तो आपको क्या करना है, हमसे जुड़े रहने के लिए जनहित आवाज को घर जा करके सब्सक्राइब जरूर करना है. और इसके अलावा आपको अवार्ड सेक्शन के बगल में चैनल सेक्शन में जाओगे तो समृद्ध भारत और वॉइस ऑफ पीपल इन चैनल को भी आप अगर सब्सक्राइब कर लेंगे तो आपकी और हमारी कनेक्टिविटी बनी रहेगी। धन्यवाद।
तो आपको क्लियर हो गया, आपको लिंक शेयर हो जाएगा, आप अपने देख सकते हैं अपनी वीडियोस की किस तरह से आपने बोला, उसको शेयर करिए, सब्सक्राइब करिए और लाइक भी करिए। ओके, एंड नेक्स्ट टाइम पे आप अच्छे से और प्रिपेयर करके आइए। जो सोच रहे थे कि हमें भी इनाम मिल जाता, तो नेक्स्ट टाइम अपनी सोच को कंप्लीट करिए और इनाम जीतिए। देयर विल बी सो मैनी ओके ओकेशंस इन विच यू विल गेट सच टाइप ऑफ प्राइजेज ऑल्सो।